I'm Chris, and this is Go for English. Today, I'm gonna teach you how to use Canva to create trivia-like activities that you can use with your students online. Canva is a platform where you can access a lot of different templates to create visuals for a lot of different media. But let's see what you can do for your online classes. Go to canva.com and on the search, click on trivia. You see there are a lot of trivia templates to choose from. I like this throwback trivia night. We are going to customize this for what we want for our classes. So let's say I want to do a simple present review. So let's say this is unit 5. I can customize it for any content, adding pages, subtracting pages in any way I like. I'll leave the mechanics section because it just explains how the game works. The next page is the category section. I'll change yes, no to right, wrong because it fits what I want better. Because of course I have already prepared my questions before I start doing this. So the first one is the easy round. So remember I want a right or wrong. And then here is the question. So I'm going to write a grammatically incorrect sentence here. So I wrote Jack work nights. Grammatically incorrect sentence. Then here, I make sure the feedback goes on to wrong, and then I give the correct answer here. And I can add some feedback. Don't forget the S in the third person singular. True or false? So now maybe I can add a grammar question. I add an S in the third person plural. False. It shows it's false. I can put an underline under the false part, that is plural. And then in the next one, I can put the correction. Now, the average round, so it's getting harder. Now it's a multiple choice. So maybe now I can have a sentence for the students to fill in the blanks with the correct form of the verb. Again, remember, if you think these questions are not enough, you can add as many as you want. I'm just giving you an example and showing you how easy it is for you to customize the Canva template to suit your own needs. So I'm gonna go here, Jack, blank, to work by train. And some alternatives. So then I'm going to repeat again here, same thing. For this one, I want to add a picture. Then I'm gonna go here, the photos, and just click on train. You want a free picture, not one that has a pro sign. So this one's free. Okay, I wanna change here, C, and here to ghosts. And then here, I'll repeat the sentence now with the correct answer. The next one is a fill-in-the-blanks exercise. You want to give students a sentence where they have just one possibility of answer. Jack rides, okay, a bike to the park. Okay, so maybe you want to make this bigger and just copy here. Just replace. Okay, now the difficult round. Enumeration. In the enumeration round, you can review vocabulary. So you can either have a blank where students can use multiple verbs, or you can have a text where you can have multiple blanks, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You decide, or you can skip this question altogether. Again, you can customize your template any way you want. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna have a text with multiple blanks for students to fill in. I'm going to change the picture to a park. Okay, so I wrote a text with 5 blanks. Jack, blank, live near the park. He and his girlfriend Sue, blank, enjoy going there on Sunday. Sue, blank, not like to stay home all day, so they, blank, not eat lunch with their parents. They always, blank, have a picnic in the park. Then on the next page, all I have to do is copy the text, the picture, post the picture again, and write the verbs. Okay, so now I've changed the page and customized it so that it has the correct answers. The next one is a video question. Cool, right? If I play this video, you see it's just a bridge. There's nothing really special about the video. But if you click here, you see there are a lot of other videos like this that you can choose from. So maybe I'll use this one that shows somebody working. I just want a short answer here. I'll repeat the video here, repeat the question, and give the answer. Drum roll please, and the winner is, and then you're gonna give your student score. Let's go back to the beginning now and present for you to see what it's gonna look like. You present to your students as you would any PowerPoint. You control it and you ask your students to answer the questions. You can download this and save it in any format, as film, as slide, as PDF, any format you prefer. A cool idea is also to ask your students to write their own Canva and share with the rest of the class. Then they can play from their own computers, why not? So, what's the advantage of using Canva over doing a simple PowerPoint presentation? First, it adds some pizzazz to your regular presentations because it has some visual elements that we usually don't use. Second, it has a lot of different templates that are ready-made that you can just customize and just use your ideas as a teacher to add to them. Of course, then you can download this presentation and have this on your computer to use in your class as many times as you want. Well, if you have any questions, suggestions, or comments, please write them below. And if you like this video, don't forget to hit the like button. Please subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And don't forget to ring the notification bell to hear about our new videos. Please share this video with your friends and follow me on my social media, Go for English, on Instagram. Bye!